Just a warning, today's episode is going to be very scientific. We're going to look at the specific gravity of wax, which is something you don't need to know at all. But if you're interested in candles and you just want to dive deep into the hobby and learn the craft and understand a little of the math involved, well, today's episode is for you. Hello and welcome to Armatage Candle Company, the premier online resource for accelerating your candle making technique and business. My name is Kevin, and in today's episode, we're going to talk about specific gravity. Now, if you're not sure what that is, don't worry, it's kind of a scientific term, but all it means is we can look at the weight of something and figure out how much space it takes up. It's kind of a measure of density, and really, that's as far as you need to understand that. Well, the deal is, in today's episode, we're going to look at that specific gravity for a bunch of different waxes on the market. And we're going to figure out exactly how much space those take up. Now, I just want to mention, you don't have to do this. This is like diving into the hobby fairly deep. Like, you don't need to know the specific gravity to be a successful candle maker. But today, just out of curiosity, just for fun, just to advance our craft, I'm going to look at it for, I think, 9 or 10 different waxes. And we're going to make a lot of candles today, a lot of different candles, a lot of different wax. It's going to be a whole thing. Let's go. Finding specific gravity is to gather all the supplies we're gonna need. We'll start out by picking out the wax, the first wax to find the specific gravity of. This is Art Minds wax, which you can find at a craft store. It's a paraffin wax. It's not very common for professional candle makers, but if you're just getting started, you might wander down to the store, pick yourself up a nice block of this stuff. The other things we're gonna need are something to measure our volume. I use a volumetric glass, but you could just as easily use a measuring cup that has milliliters or cups listed on it. We're gonna need a scale to measure the weight of the wax once we've melted it down. And it doesn't hurt to have a calculator and something to take notes with. So let's go ahead and melt this down and then we'll pour it into here and I'll show you the next step. So the nice part about this experiment is I don't have to worry about measuring out how much wax I'm going to put in, as long as I know that I'll be able to measure it in some sort of measuring glass at some point. It doesn't matter how much I get it up to or how much the wax fills a container, as long as it goes to something that I can identify as like a clear, this is 200 milliliters or this is 1 cup. All right, we're all melted down now, so now it's just a matter of pouring it into a beaker. So I'm going to set this down. It's important that you can measure exactly how much volume is in there. Volume is milliliters or cups, or if you're crazy, fluid ounces, but don't do that. Just please don't. So I've teared the weight of this. I don't want to include the weight of my beaker. I just want the weight of the melted wax. Now, it doesn't matter what temperature the wax is at. It really doesn't. And I'm going to pour until I meet a very clear measurement. So I'm going to take this one to 150 milliliters. So pouring that in, we end up with 129 grams. And if I look at that, if we measure that, that's roughly 153 milliliters. So I'll record that here. 129 grams, 159 milliliters. So now that we know our weight and we know our volume, we can calculate our density. But that's not going to be enough, not quite yet. We have to take that density and convert it into a specific gravity, and then we can plug it into the formula. Show them the formula again. Right. If you haven't seen that video, go check it out now. You should probably know that before we start getting into the nitty-gritty of this. But let's do a few more waxes, and then I'll show you on my computer exactly how you can take all this data and transition it into something you can use for your formulas. So with that out of the way, I wrote down every weight and volume we did for all six waxes. And now it's time to calculate our specific gravity. And I could do this with a calculator and a pen and a pencil, but I think it's going to be easier if I just show you how I do it on a computer. So let's switch over to that now. Okay, so I've taken all that stuff I wrote down by hand and I put it in a nice little table here. And this is just Google Sheets. It's a free product. It's a cloud product. And if you haven't read my article about my suggested digital toolbox, go do that later. The link is down in the description. I think it's great to get you started, help you get organized, some cool tools for you. In any case, I took all of our measurements and I put them in here, and we'll eventually calculate that specific gravity. But let's talk about what that is very briefly. Well, specific gravity, just basic scientific definition, is a relative density of something compared to water. And so if you know the density of a material, in our case wax, and you divide it by the density of water, that's your specific gravity. It's really not that complicated. It's just a weird name. And then the total weight, the second equation we have here, is the total weight of what has to go into a container. And that is the water weight multiplied by the specific gravity. So what does this mean? If you fill a container with water and you measure that, that is your water weight, just the weight of the water in that container. Well, specific gravity allows us to convert that water weight into a wax blend weight for the container. So it's really just, it's kind of a Rosetta Stone for wax to water. And the third equation is what we use all the time in candle making. And this is how we take and figure out, and we split that total weight into wax and fragrance. And this is how we calculate the wax half of that. And that's just taking your total weight of what fits in that container, and you divide that by one plus the fragrance load. And there's a whole video on this. Go watch that if you want to learn a little more what that's talking about. But the essence of, if I take B and substitute it into C for our total weight, we get a more complicated looking equation, but more comprehensive. And that is to calculate the wax you need for a container. That's equal to the total weight, which we know is the water weight times the specific gravity, divided by one plus the fragrance load. So how is this useful? Well, every wax might have slightly different specific gravities, which means you require a different amount of that wax depending on your candle. So knowing the specific gravity allows you to very fine tune with math the amount of wax that you need to fill a container for that wax. So it's a wax specific calculation. And now, like I said before, it's not critical that you do this. You can be successful in candle making without doing any of this nonsense, but it's kind of cool, especially if you're a geek like me and you're really into candles. So let's take our calculations here, what we wrote down for measurements, and let's actually find the specific gravity for the six different waxes that we looked at. So in the lower left, I put kind of the characteristics of water, the density of water, and in the metric units, it's super slick. It's just about 1 gram per milliliter. That's a density, how much weight something takes up per space. And that's not by accident. The metric system was designed very well to help us with that. But when we want to find the specific gravity of our wax, we take the density of the wax, which we're going to calculate here, and we divide it by the density of water, which is 1, if we're using grams per milliliter. If you see where I'm going, everything gets really super easy if you measure in grams per milliliter, because divided by 1 is the same number. So I skipped the step in our table of calculating the density. I jumped right to specific gravity because I measured everything on purpose in grams and milliliters. So without further ado, let's go ahead and fill in this last table here. So our specific gravity equals our grams divided by our milliliters, and technically divided by 1. I'm going to skip the divided by 1 step and see that our specific gravity for the Art Minds paraffin, the stuff that you get at Hobby Lobby, is 0.84. And I'll take my formula and just drag it down here. Super simple. But you can see we have quite a variety of specific gravities. They're all kind of close to each other, which isn't surprising considering wax. But the trend I see here immediately is that soy wax is the most dense. A high specific gravity also means a higher density. Soy wax is the most dense wax out of the six.
And paraffin, not surprisingly, is the lowest density wax out of the six. And this plays into how well it throws. We know that in general, paraffin wax candles throw better than soy. And you can kind of think of it as because it's lighter. It doesn't require as much energy to throw a lighter, less dense wax into the air than it does something heavier like soy. So that kind of helps us understand that. And a lot of these other waxes land somewhere in the middle of that.
Well, that was cool. I hope that was kind of insightful, a little bit helpful. Here's some final thoughts for you to take on your way for your next candle, if you're going to do this on your own or whatever. The first is this. The trend is that soy ends up being a little more dense than paraffin. Paraffin is usually a little lighter. Now, the numbers that came out of this study are very relatively specific to the batch of wax that I have. You may come out with slightly different numbers. The trends should still be there, soy being a little more dense than paraffin, other things kind of landing in the middle. But really, this is based on my measurements with my tools, my specific wax, because wax does change. Different batches that you get may be a little different. The second part is that although I call this kind of an advanced math candle thing, it's not the cool kind of advanced that means you're somehow better than everyone or that you're better than other people who don't know, because the honest truth is, like, calculating specific gravity and density, you don't need that. You don't need that at all to be a successful candle maker. So, like, don't worry if this is still a little confusing, if you still have questions. If there is anything else you want to know, or if you have some insight of your own, please leave me a comment. Otherwise, I thought it was just an interesting experiment to pull off and look at kind of the general feel, general density of some waxes on the market, especially that Hobby Lobby wax. I've been curious about that thing for quite a long time. So anyways, I hope some of this was useful to you. I hope some of it was helpful to you. There's some links in the description. I've got a whole article about density and specific gravity that you can go read if you want. Otherwise, I hope you have a great week. I hope you are making beautiful candles, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye!